I'm TJ Manoto, and this is your TFC News Now.
We're getting a clearer picture of the total devastation Hurricane Helene left behind in southeastern U.S. states. As of Monday, at least 120 people have been killed in six states, and officials fear the death toll can rise, with many still unaccounted for, perhaps unable to leave their location or don't have the means to communicate with family or friends, especially since more than 2 million people remain without power. Government officials and aid groups have been trying to get much-needed supplies by airlift or truck to the hardest-hit areas, but have encountered challenges due to hundreds of roads closed or remaining unpassable. Helene made landfall as a Category 4 hurricane in Florida's Big Bend region last week, and thereafter ripped through Tennessee, Georgia, the Carolinas, and Virginia.
This area was totally submerged in water.
Filipina Daphne Versosa, a Tampa, Florida resident, is used to hurricanes hitting the state, but she says Helene's wrath was the worst her family had ever experienced, especially with its unexpected storm surge.
This hurricane was really terrible for our community, for Florida, and for Tampa Bay specifically. We honestly didn't expect it to be this bad.
Meanwhile, President Joe Biden plans to visit some of the areas hit by Hurricane Helene later this week, as soon as it will not disrupt emergency response operations, according to the White House. Presidential candidates have also used the campaign trail to express their condolences and support to the victims of Helene. Donald Trump, who was scheduled to help hand out supplies in Valdosta, Georgia on Monday, slammed Biden and Vice President Harris, alleging they had a slow response to the deadly storm. While on a rally in Las Vegas, Harris expressed solidarity with affected communities and spoke about relief efforts.
More than 3,300 federal personnel have been mobilized. We are deploying food, water, and generators and working to restore water and power. And the President and I have told state and local leaders we will provide whatever help they need in the days and weeks ahead.
And finally, we head to Alberta, Canada, where the iconic 90s Filipino band Rivermaya reunited on stage to the delight of 7,000 fans filling the PV Mart Centrum in Red Deer.
I love it. Ano nangyari sa show, no? Na soundcheck pa lang, 400 people, the venue packed to the gills. So, saya lang lahat. At maraming salamat sa lahat ng nanood.
Well, nagsimula ito sa yung first show sa Manila. Nagkaroon ng request na dalhin yung show sa iba pang parte ng mundo. So, ayan, may pinta tayo paano sa North America, Lake.
Ginawa niyong napakasaya ang aming first time dito. Actually, first time tumugtog ng classic lineup ng Rivermaya dito sa Canada. Dito sa Red Deer, first time. Ito ata so far yung pinakamaraming tao sa past 3 shows namin. So thank you lalong-lalo na yung mga nanggaling sa malayong lugar. Sa mga kaibigan namin na dumayo, maraming salamat.
And those are the news making headlines today. You can catch more of our TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website and YouTube channel. I'm TJ Manotok. Stay with us, Kapamilya.